Dear students, today we are going to learn the poem The Election from the text Indian Constitution. Get ready everyone. Once again, note the name of the poem The Election by Sita Kanta Mahapatra. At first, about the poet. Sita Kanta Mahapatra was born in 1937 in Orissa. He is not only a poet, translator, but also a critic. He is a bilingual writer. He has used both Oriya and English for his writings. He was awarded the Jnanapeeth in 1993 and the Padma Bhushan in 2002. The poem reflects the different aspects of life, culture, and tradition of Orissa. The poem is translated from Oriya by the poet himself. Then come to the poem. The poem describes an election scenario from a village in North India. The speaker of the poem is not the poet, but an election campaigner. He is objectively looking at the village people and tricks played in the campaign. A jeep crawls under the roaring sun, seeking the votes for the candidate. A jeep crawls under the roaring sun, seeking the votes for their candidate. The jeep crawls. What it shows? It shows the pathetic condition of the road in the village. The people are visibly in misery, and the political parties arrange trappings like posters, symbols, speeches, and handbills, along with cheap plastic, cheaper nylon, dark glasses to blot out the sun. It is very easy to trap them. Their misery has a long history. It is very difficult for them to make a choice. The speaker, the election campaigner, says that they pass through an anguish of choice. An anguish of choice. What do you mean by anguish? Anguish means physical pain as well as mental pain. So, the speaker says that they pass through an anguish of choice with one foot in hunger and the other in the soul. One foot in hunger and the other in the soul. One foot in hunger. It shows people are living in misery. That defects democratic spirit. The speaker says that they pass through an anguish of choice with one foot in hunger and the other in the soul. That is, these little things tempt them to vote for a particular party. These little things tempt them to vote for a particular party. Why? This is also a chance for them to express their political will. The choice is not easy for them to make. The anguish of the choice is seen on their face. They sell their vote for money. They sell. They vote for money. And little things like plastic and dark glasses, and are not aware of the fact that they are selling democracy itself. We understood that the speaker of the poem is an election campaigner. And the theme of the poem is an election campaign in a village. The poem deals with an election campaign in a village. There is also another theme in the poem, that is ethics in such campaigns in democratic elections. There are two sections of people in the poem. They are ordinary people and those who campaign. What are the great pursuers? The great pursuers are the little things like cheap plastic, cheaper nylon, and the dark glasses to blot out the sun. The irony is that the great pursuers are cheap things. In the poem, there is a phrase, one foot in hunger and one in the soul. What do you mean by one foot in hunger? The people are living in misery and depressing poverty, which defects the democratic spirit. To put it briefly, the poem suggests how extreme poverty undermines democracy. I will come back with another lesson tomorrow.